Hello everyone. This is electrical engineer Igor Ekimov. Today we will look at an interesting thermostat TEOK TC-TE81B Wi-Fi from TEOK. It can be used as a programmable thermostat without an internet connection, and it can also be controlled via the internet and used as part of a smart home. This thermostat has a nice black design, a large touch screen with large orange numbers and icons. The display is removable, which is convenient when renovating rooms. The thermostat is used to regulate the room temperature, using heated floors and other heating equipment. I left a link to the store where I ordered the thermostat in the description. Subscribe to the channel so as not to miss new videos. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. In the video, I will look at how to install and connect the thermostat, how to set it up in automatic and manual mode, and I will also show how to control it remotely via the internet using a phone and voice. Let's look at the features of connecting this thermostat. The wires are fixed with screw clamps. The warm floor is connected to the first two terminals. The neutral is connected to the third terminal. The phase is connected to the fourth. Particular attention should be paid to the correct connection of the phase and neutral. Otherwise, the neutral will be interrupted and the warm floor will be constantly under the phase. An external temperature sensor is connected to two separate terminals. The kit includes a sensor with a 3-meter cord. But another 10-comb sensor will do if it is already connected to the installation site. All terminals must be tightly clamped. Check the correct connection of the wires again. Incorrect connection can lead to failure of the thermostat. This thermostat is easy to install. Pull the display up, and it comes off. We can take out this connector and put the display away for the duration of the repair. There are two holes here to secure the thermostat with screws to the wall box. The first and the second. The thermostat is assembled in the reverse order. Put the connector in place. Put the display back on the fixing plate. We check that all the mounting plate fasteners are in place. Then we lower the display down. The thermostat is assembled. The thermostat takes up 2.5 centimeters in the wall box, and the supply wires fit easily in the wall box. The thermostat has a large black screen with 5 touch buttons. The screen displays information in large orange numbers and icons, which looks quite impressive. The information is clearly visible if you look at the screen straight on or from above, from almost any angle. The screen is large, 8.5 by 8.5 centimeters. So it is not suitable for embedding in blocks with other sockets. Standard frames are usually 8 by 8 centimeters. It should be placed separately. There is an additional protective film on the screen, which can be removed immediately after repair. At the bottom is a built-in ambient temperature sensor, which is connected by default. If you plan to use the thermostat to control underfloor heating, then this sensor must be replaced with an external one in the settings. I will explain how to do this later. This thermostat can switch an active load of up to 3.5 kilowatts. Adjust the temperature from 5 to 45 degrees. It is possible to increase the upper adjustment level to 90 degrees. The room temperature for installing the thermostat should be between minus 5 and 50 degrees. Avoid installing the thermostat in damp rooms and places where water splashes may hit the thermostat. All settings are stored in the non-volatile memory of the device. This button can be used to switch the operating modes of the thermostat. Here is the clock. This is the automatic mode of the thermostat. Here, I press the button and switch to manual mode. This is indicated by the palm icon on the display. In this mode, the controller maintains the set temperature for a long time. The room temperature is displayed here, and the set temperature is displayed here. We can raise it using these keys, we can lower it. I can also do this remotely. Here I raise the temperature from the application and here I lower it. If the sensor temperature is higher than the set temperature, the heating does not turn on. Let's raise the temperature. Here I have set the set temperature to 33 degrees. And, as you can see, the heating icon has turned on. Here, we decrease the temperature and the icon has turned off. The heated floors are disabled. The thermostat has child protection. Here we hold down the plus and minus together. And our lock lights up. Now the thermostat does not respond to pressing the keys. Here we hold down the plus and minus again. And our lock disappears. I can also turn on the lock from the application. Here I have locked the keyboard. Here I have removed the lock. I will tell you more about working in the application later. You can turn the thermostat on and off with this button. Here we have turned it off and on. Before turning on the program mode, you need to set the clock. To do this, press the clock button. Our clock starts blinking. Using the plus and minus keys, we can adjust the value. Press again. We can adjust the minutes and set the days of the week. Press again, and the setup is complete. If the thermostat is connected to the internet, the clock is set automatically, as in my case. To switch to the program mode, press this button. Here we have a clock displayed. In this case, the day is divided into intervals, and icons are displayed below, symbolizing the interval in which this thermostat is located. Each interval has its own settings. On the right, the temperature is displayed, which is maintained during this period of time. The thermostat regulates the temperature in the weekly cycle mode. The default mode is 5 plus 2, that is, 5 weekdays and 2 weekends are set separately. You can set 6 plus 1 and 7 plus 0. We will talk about this later. On weekdays, 6 time intervals with their own temperature settings are set, and 2 time intervals on weekends. In this case, icons are displayed below, symbolizing the interval in which this thermostat is located. Here is an example of setting the thermostat in automatic mode. Here are the settings for a weekday. 1. Wake up. 2. Leaving for work. 3. Coming for lunch. The 4th is leaving for work after lunch. The 5th is coming home from work. The 6th is night sleep. There are only 2 modes for the weekend, day and night. The start time of the interval and the maintained temperature should be adjusted to your needs. To do this, turn off the thermostat and hold down the mode switching button and the clock for a long time. And we have entered the setup mode. Here we are for the working day. For the first interval, we set the clock. We switch, set the minutes. We switch, we set the temperature. We switch, then we set the second interval. The third. The fourth. The fifth. The sixth. Next, we set the weekend. The start of the day. Here we have set 8 o'clock. And the second interval, going to bed, we have set 2300. We can also change. For example, to 10 o'clock. We set the night temperature to 15 degrees. We wait 10 seconds and the settings are saved. Or we can turn the thermostat off and on. If we have the automatic mode working, but we need a different temperature, we can adjust it. Here we raise the temperature and lower it. This is the comfort mode. As you can see, it is displayed on the display with a palm and a clock. The set temperature value will be valid until the beginning of the next time interval of the thermostat program. Then the thermostat will switch to automatic mode. To get more options from the thermostat, you need to go to the advanced settings mode. To do this, turn off the thermostat. And then simultaneously hold the mode and minus buttons. Here we have moved to the advanced settings. The first item, we can adjust the temperature sensor readings if necessary. Press. Select the sensor. The built-in sensor is set by default. Here we have switched to the external sensor. We can turn on both sensors at once. To work with a warm floor, I recommend turning on the external OU sensor. Press. The next item is overheating protection. It is adjusted from 5 to 60 degrees. I leave the default setting of 60 degrees. The next item is hysteresis. I leave it at 1 degree. Then freeze protection. The thermostat will turn on automatically. If the temperature drops below the set lower limit, and then the thermostat will maintain this temperature. Next, switching the number of working and non-working days. By default, 5 working days and 2 days off. You can set 6 working days, 1 day off, 7 working days, 0 days off. If we turn on the off mode, the program mode is disabled. Next, the maximum temperature. It can be adjusted from 30 to 90 degrees if necessary. I prefer to leave 40 degrees the default setting. Next, the minimum temperature is adjusted from 5 to 20 degrees. I set 5 degrees. Next, we set the load power. 1 is up to 1.5 kilowatts. 2 up to 2.5 kilowatts. 3 up to 3.5 kilowatts. I leave up to 1.5 kilowatts. Next, reset to factory settings. To do this, you need to hold the plus key for 5 seconds, but I will not do this. Next, the settings are switched in a circle. We turn off and on the thermostat and go to the operating mode. Now let's see how to connect the thermostat to the internet. First, find and download the smart home application. The manufacturer recommends using Smart Life, Tuya Smart and Yandex Smart Home. But other applications that work with a smart home using the Tuya Smart System will do as well. I installed Tuya Home for myself. I also connected this thermostat to the Minimir Home application. If you already use a smart home, then perhaps you can connect this thermostat to it. The installation is quite simple. Find the Google Play application and register in it. I already have the Tuya Home application installed, so I click open. You will have to install. After registration, a page like this will open for you. To connect the thermostat to a smart home, turn on Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on your phone. Turn off the thermostat and press the plus and minus buttons at the same time. All elements of the screen light up. Now we turn off the thermostat and turn it on again. And, as you can see, the Wi-Fi icon is blinking. Now we click the plus sign, add device. And as you can see, the application has automatically detected the thermostat. If your thermostat is not detected automatically, then press other and press another Wi-Fi. Fill in the data of the Wi-Fi network in which the thermostat will work. Next, confirm that our indicator is blinking and press forward. And as you can see, our thermostat is being installed. The thermostat is installed, press finished. And my thermostat control page immediately turned on. Now Bluetooth can be disabled, and you will be able to control the thermostat settings in this application from anywhere in the world. The main thing is that you and the thermostat are connected to the internet. Now let's control the thermostat remotely. At the top, you can replace the name with a more convenient one. I leave the thermostat. Further, it is indicated that the thermostat works in manual mode. This can be changed by pressing the mode button. Here, we pressed and selected the automatic mode. And this was immediately displayed on the thermostat. Let's exit. Below, we can forcibly set the temperature on the thermostat. Using the plus and minus buttons. Here we raise, lower. Below we can turn off the anti-freeze mode. Turn it back on. Here we can turn on the key lock. Turned on. Turned off. All this is displayed on the thermostat indicators. You can use this button to turn the thermostat off and on. We have already discussed the mode button. Press setting. Here we can adjust the thermostat settings in a convenient format. We can also choose here which sensor will be connected. Select a remote sensor. And here in a convenient format we can choose in which automatic mode the thermostat will work. Or turn off the automatic mode altogether. Turn on 5 working days and 2 days off. Here we can adjust the time intervals and temperature in a more convenient format. Both on working days and on weekends. For example, take and adjust. The thermostat can be controlled by voice. To do this, you need to install the Smart Home with Alice application and connect our application to it. I already have a Home with Alice installed. Let's update it. In addition to the thermostat, I have other devices installed. Here is our thermostat. As you can see, you can manually control the thermostat through this application. Here I turned it off and on. I can adjust the temperature. It is also important that I link the thermostat to the corridor. The word corridor can be used to control the thermostat. To control it with your voice, you need to press the Alice icon. Hello, Alice.
Привет, как я могу помочь вам сегодня?
Alice, increase the temperature to 30 degrees.
Меняю температуру.
Press again. Alice will increase the temperature to 35 degrees.
Делаю.
As you can see, the temperature on the thermostat has risen to 35 degrees and the heating has turned on. Alice, turn off the thermostat in the corridor.
Окей, выключаем.
As you can see, the thermostat is off. Press again. Alice, turn on the heating in the corridor.
Устройство сообщает мне, что оно этого не умеет.
Alice, turn on the thermostat.
Включаю.
As you can see, Alice has turned on the thermostat. Everything works, but there is an inconvenience. You need to press the Alice icon every time before entering a command. For greater convenience, you need to connect a speaker with Alice. Sometimes Alice does not understand your commands. She needs to be trained a little. Let's draw conclusions. It is worth noting the versatility and multifunctionality of this thermostat from TEOK. You can first install it as a regular programmable thermostat, later connect it to the application on your smartphone and control it remotely. The next step is to integrate it into the smart home system. For small repairs, it is convenient that this display is removable. You do not need to remove the thermostat entirely. It has a pretty nice design and will fit into almost any interior. But it is worth considering that you need to leave a separate socket box for this thermostat. This thermostat is useful when your life schedule fits into a weekly mode, and this schedule almost does not change. When changing the schedule, either turn on the thermostat in manual mode or reprogram it. Moreover, you can reprogram or control it remotely. In the following videos, I will also consider other automation devices for a smart home and more. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell so as not to miss these videos. I will be grateful for your likes and reposts. Write your questions and your experience with similar thermostats in the comments. See you in new and old videos.